Hey guys, have you ever struggled with your hair soaking wet and you don't like it down your back and you just don't like it down whatsoever? You try to grab a paper towel or a little t-shirt to dry the ends because it's dripping and you're pretty much just frustrated because it's just not working out. Well, I'm gonna show you how you can plop your hair with a cotton t-shirt so your hair is not down your back, dripping wet, and your curls can get much more defined and it can speed up drying time. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get down to the video and I'm gonna show you guys how I plop my curly hair. Back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about how to plop your hair. You guys probably saw in some of my videos I do like plopping with a cotton t-shirt, so today I figured, you know what, like, let me specifically make this video for plopping because you guys are probably like, Sam, we want you to talk about it. That's what today's video is going to be about, and if you guys want to know how to plop your hair, continue watching. Now today I'm going to be showing you guys how I plop with a cotton t-shirt. There's another way to plop, which is that way, and then there's the wet plopping, which is with the shower cap, and I use a wet cap, and that's typically what you do when after you style your hair. You can do it both ways. I do the wet cap and then I do the cotton t-shirt. It doesn't matter. If you guys want me to do the wet plopping, I will show you guys in a separate video. I feel like it's the same results. The only difference is that I don't diffuse my hair when I use a cotton t-shirt. If I do the wet plopping, once I leave my hair inside, I usually use a diffuser and I go throughout my whole entire head with the blow dryer and I just like blow dry my hair and then I use the diffuser to curl my curls. But like I said, that's a separate video. If you guys wanna see that part of wet plopping and how I do it, I will make a different video for you guys. If you guys want to see that, go ahead and leave that in the comments if you guys want to see how I do my wet plopping. But today, like I said, we're going to be doing the cotton t-shirt method, and I'm going to show you guys how I plop with a cotton t-shirt. I recently posted a picture of me wet plopping my hair, and I'll post it right here. Since I posted that picture, some of you have asked me, Sam, what exactly is plopping? The reason why I plop my hair is because I don't like having my hair dry down my back. I don't like the wetness in my back. You guys know that if you see my videos, I hate that. And that's why I always put my hair up. I typically do the t-shirt ploppings. Why I do that is because it speeds up my drying time. So when I plop my hair, the water is being absorbed from the t-shirts or from my hair. So it speeds up the drying time. Another reason why I do it is because my hair looks really nice after. It looks defined. Since my hair is in the cotton t-shirt, my hair is actually being scrunched up. And when all that water is absorbed by the t-shirt, when I let my hair down, my hair looks really good. Like, my curls look on point. Some people I've seen, they plop for deep conditioning. They put like the shower cap and they do the plopping because of the heat inside of the hair. Some people plop while before bed, which I don't like to do because I can't sleep with wet hair. For some reason, when I wake up in the morning, I get sick. I don't know why. Maybe because the AC's blowing, the fan's blowing, and you know, I just can't wash my hair at night because I feel like I get sick in the morning. I don't know if that's just me. I typically plop during the day, then I leave the shirt on throughout the day until my hair is like really dry. Sometimes I have to switch out the shirt because the shirt be soaking wet, and then I have to like put another shirt in to absorb the water from my hair. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how I plop my hair. And yeah, let's go ahead. So what I typically do when it comes to plopping is I grab a t-shirt. Normally it's my husband's t-shirt because his shirt is bigger and it can hold all of my hair. So I normally grab a t-shirt of his. Normally it's white or sometimes it's colored if he doesn't have a white t-shirt on hand. So I go ahead and grab a t-shirt. I lay it down on the bed. And then I go ahead and flip my hair over. And when I flip my hair over, I just go ahead and make sure that all of my hair is going in the same direction. And I just go ahead and place my hair very gently in the middle part of the t-shirt. I don't just throw my hair in any kind of way. I just very gently, like here, place my hair into the t-shirt. Very self-explanatory. Then I grab the ends of the shirt that is towards me. And I go ahead and wrap the shirt very tightly around the nape of my neck. As you guys can see, I just make sure I hold it down. I just realized you guys couldn't see the other side, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn my head so you guys can see what I'm doing. So I'm grabbing both ends, putting it at the bottom of my hairline. Is that what you call it? And then I go ahead and make sure my hair is inside the shirt, because sometimes it could be out of the shirt. But I grab the top of the shirt, and while I'm holding down where we put the shirt at the nape of the neck, I'm making sure that it doesn't become loose or anything. And then I go ahead and hold the shirt like so. So once you have your shirt looking like this, you want to go ahead and tuck the sides. I like to tuck the sides. You could probably leave it out if you want, but I just tuck the sides because I feel like it doesn't look
weird or feel off balance. And then I go ahead and start to tie the shirt. Now, sometimes you can let your ears breathe if you want. Sometimes you don't got to let your ears breathe, but I let my ears out so I can hear better. And then I just go ahead and tie the shirt. I tie it twice because sometimes it can get loose, so I just double tie it. So once you're done tying it, that's pretty much it. You can go about your day, do chores, sleep, eat, do whatever you want. Your hair is not going to become loose. It is going to dry a little faster than it normally would if it was down your back. But as long as you are not dealing with the dripping wet hair down your back, this is how I do it. So I always do this. This is my favorite way of plopping my hair. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
But yeah, that's pretty much it on this video. I hope I gave you guys a better understanding of how to plop your curly hair. Really simple, easy, especially if you have long hair. If you guys think you can't plop your hair if it's super long, you can. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. All right, bye guys.